It was a tough decision to make, deciding this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. My family, my friends, my children, they inspire me to follow my dreams, to become the musician I am today. We travel far and wide, but we never forget where we started. It's where we come from that shapes where we go. An island of peace, far removed from the busy world. It's what we call home. It's where heroes are made.
Every time I would have, like, someone would come and stand there with my sister. People like to sing a song, a ghazal. It's a surprising thing for Assamese people that kids are singing a ghazal. Like, wow, Urdu bhi lag raha hai. You know, what is this? So either it will be like, no, sing. Beta, you know, sing, it's so nice. You have to, you know, be like how your dad and mom is. So there's a comparison all the time. Doesn't matter what I sing or not. Or it will be like, obviously he's good because, you know, son of Kogan and also Namanto. So, not a big deal about my magic of singing. So I needed to, you know, that's why I think it was pushing me away from music. Away? In a good way, till the distance, to see it from there. So when I had to make a choice, so I made a choice for architecture. I mean, because I used to paint very well. So take it. That was the plan. Very, I don't know where it got torn here and there. And somewhere I understood that no, I've been chosen, and maybe hanging out in Delhi kind of gave me that feeling that, you know, I stand alone on my own merit, on my own talent, on my own understanding of music. Not just because parents be musicians there, so I have to sing. Not because of that. So then I found my calling. Then I wanted to specialize in music. Basically, when I was working on the jingles and stuff, I had figured out my production side of it. Then I was traveling a lot to the mountains again. Like, you know, mountains, whenever I go, I get this new beautiful tune, I'll record it. I don't remember, maybe a small dictaphone kind of thing. And I'll come and produce them. So slowly, slowly, over a few years, I had got these beautiful musicians' friends from Delhi, Assam, to come over. And many musicians worked on the album. So it took me like 7 years or so to compile 10 songs or 9 songs. 8 songs, actually. Because I had already got so many songs, so I also wanted to make an album. I made the album cover myself, designed it. I didn't want to have the face, I wanted to have my backside. You know, and like little subtle stuff I wanted to do. I wanted to change something which was happening here, maybe. I was not really sure what's going to come also with this. Like how big Junaki Rati happened, my first album. I had no clue till like 5 years of it. It became like a cult album. People tattooing my name. How big, what kind of love is that? Like I didn't realize what I created had become way bigger than I would have actually ever thought of. I was playing around after Junaki Rati, playing live with the band from here. These are great guys, we're rock kind of guys, and I have kind of transformed them a little bit into ghazal, a little bit into Indianness. And they had a different approach, so it made it way more interesting. I said, listen, let's go to Delhi, sit there for a while, make an album, and let's play this music, a little different than this, to the world. Let's just play it to the world and see how it goes. I have a strong belief that this will really work. And people love this. This is never heard of. Then came Bollywood. Then came Pritam, then came Rohan Sipi meeting me through a medieval pandit's gig somewhere. He saw me, he's like, bro, you want to sing for a movie? I'm like, yes. And then Pritam called me one day saying, Papon, I love what you're doing. I want you to sing this song. I'm like, yes. So I sent it to Delhi. I sang it in Delhi in my own house. And when I went there back, I sang GAQ again for them because they said, okay, this is good. Let's record it properly now in the studio. We did. It didn't work out. I mean, that moment you capture, that's when I realized slowly, slowly more that more than technicalities what we have, it's a moment. If you have captured it, you can reproduce or you can work on it post whatever way. But that moment cannot be recreated. So GAQ in my bedroom in Delhi is still the voice in the movie, and they decided to scrap everything new recording and get the old recording. Now where we are enjoying the mix of the band, where we also using like Bollywood or you know any kind of commercial music which is way popular on a different version on stage. This is the EIC version, East India Company version. We take it like that and we like the way people like the music. At the same time, through that, because more and more people know you, we are also able to push in the other kind of the indie music. And then people come to our concerts because of maybe a Bollywood song and suddenly realize, oh, what is that? And then they will listen to it again. So we are able to balance both the sides. There was a mission. I wanted to go and put my flag everywhere. Like, see, I'm from the Northeast. This is the music. It's amazing. So that was it. I mean, but not imposing. You know, it has to be enjoyable. It has to be by everyone, anywhere in the world. That's why the new mix. That's why the global mix in my music. Where I think then it's easy to receive it from wherever you are in the world.